Wow, Noelle, look at that slit. You look like an actress.
Personally, I don't think I look like an actress, but when my mom tells me that I do, my heart swells. It makes me feel good about myself, and I know that my mom has always wanted to see me how I am now. To be able to give that to her was really a huge occasion for me.
Your makeup, you look beautiful.
Lots of parents get choked up when they see their kids dressed up for the prom for the first time. But when you have like a transgender child, it just means that much more because this is something that is difficult for them. They live in a cisgender world and their mothers are seeing them in a light they never thought they would.
I'm going from one to the next of you. You have brought out the best in each one of you. And it's amazing.
Going to prom for Jazz is something that I don't think she probably thought about very much in the past. I think she just made another world for herself in her bedroom with the pussycats and the television and overeating and all of the things that comforted her. The fact that she's agreed to go to the prom and go with her dear girlfriends and possibly having a good time is growth.
Just have a grand evening, have a lot of fun, and remember it forever.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
All right, guys, pictures with the pool and lake in the background, okay?
Hold on, wait. Before we take pictures, there's one last surprise. Come on down!
Hey!
Hey!
What's up, guys?
Look who's coming to prom
what
with
a man.
Us!
I'm gonna be your guys' escort down
we
at
We have
prom
an escort.
Today.
It's the cisgendered friend, the wingman.
That's me.
Sandra and Jazz are really bonding without Griffin in the house. And he wanted to take Jazz to the prom. I think it's really sweet. I'm happy. I'm like, he's just my guy to take care of my girls.
All right, now let's take pictures.
Okay, let's do it.
Sandra taking us to prom, I think it's a little funny and quirky, but I think it was a sweet gesture. I mean, he is cute too, so, you know, win-win.
Okay, one, two, three, smile. I really hope that Jazz comes home from this evening, like, jumping out of her skin. That was so great. I danced, Mom. Look at these pictures. I met some really cool kids. That's what I want.
Are you ready to get going?
No, I'm very ready.
Before our makeup like melts off?
Yes,
it's already
definitely.
Melting off. I look like colored Crisco.
Let's do it. This prom looks absolutely amazing. Between the music and all of the people, everything looks so much fun. I'm actually ready to party.
Everyone in here is just so beautiful. A lot of very pretty people.
Thank you.
You know I was talking about you.
This prom is gorgeous. Everything about it is absolutely prom. Like, it feels like a real prom.
Guys, how do you feel about the vibe? It's loud, that's for sure.
Is this your first time at prom?
I can't hear you.
It is really, really loud at this prom with the music and all of the people screaming to the music. I could barely hear my friends from across the table. Anything I could do?
Yeah, I don't want to go in there again.
The screaming freaks me out.
It hurts my heart to see Noelle suffering from a PTSD episode right now.
Just everything is messed up right now.
You know, she's just trying to live her life and enjoy prom, but she can't even have fun.
I mean, like, being in loud, crowded spaces just sucks right now. I genuinely feel like, no matter how irrational it is, I feel like someone's gonna walk in with a gun.
No, that is not irrational. I can't imagine what that's like for Noelle to have seen her friends being killed before her eyes.
Like, I can hear the gunshots because when I was rushing out to the courtyard when everything was happening, I heard 3 gunshots, and it turns out they were one of the last 3 when his gun started jamming. And, man,
we don't have to go back in there.
You can go in if you want.
No, I'm not leaving you. Although, actually, there is cheesecake. I need to bring out the cheesecake for you. And then, do you want me to ask the other friends if they want to come out here for a little?
I'm going to be honest. I don't want to ruin any of your nights.
No, it's not. I'm going to get everyone else. Noelle is really suffering from this, you know? This is real PTSD. She is having a difficult time, and no one deserves to feel this way. And I just really want to do whatever I can to make her feel happier.
Do you guys want to go hang out with us over there? She's not doing well because she has PTSD when she hears loud noises, and it's just a little loud and overwhelming.
Does she want to go?
I myself have never been in a shooting, but I have heard guns before, and it's one of the worst sounds ever. It's traumatizing.
Look, I got the whole posse.
I want to be there for Noelle, but I feel so helpless. No matter how hard I try, I can't put myself in her shoes, and I can't tell her that I think everything is going to be all right.
The only thing that really helps me get through these happenings are the love and support that family and friends give me. It really helps when they're around me.
How you doing?
I'm sorry. The screaming freaks me out.
Let's go outside. You won't be able to hear anything.
Thank you.
Of course.
I tend to think that I'm getting better and I'm getting over everything as the days go on. I have less problems or I have no problems. And then one day like this will hit me and I can't handle anything, and it feels like the world is crumbling.